Today we're going to talk about an important subject matter in relation to women's reproductive system. The subject is uterine fibroids. Uterine fibroids is one of the commonest tumors or growths that affect the women's reproductive system. It actually occurs most of the time in the uterus. That's why they are called uterine fibroids. But it's not unusual to find them outside the uterus, in which situation we refer to them as parasitic fibroids. Parasitic in that they have become parasites outside their domain. Now, uterine fibroids most often afflict or affect women in the reproductive age, but more so after age of 25 years. But again, as usual, as often happens, to every rule there are exceptions. A few times we've found fibroids in teenagers. You could have one or two. Some can grow very big even in those early ages. But to the effect that they occur in women of reproductive age, particularly beyond 25 years, it has been established that a few issues may be resultant to their occurrence. One of those being that maybe a woman has started her reproductive life very late or a little late than expected. Of course, you know that as far as God is concerned, once you attain reproductive maturity, which is, of course, when you see your menstrual period, it means you are a fertile woman and you can get pregnant. But in modern times, we delay childbirth because of career pursuit, going to school, etc., etc. And these are some of the things that have been associated with development of uterine fibroids in women. That is delaying childbirth. The other association is not necessarily delaying childbirth, but probably having babies very wide apart. You can have one at 18 years, then you choose to have the next maybe at 30 years, and then another one at 40 years. That also still predisposes you to developing uterine fibroids. The other factor that is associated, which is not far from what we are talking about, is the fact of not having babies at all. In other words, being infertile. Or not necessarily being infertile, you just choose not to have babies. So women who don't have babies at all into their late ages, or who don't have them because they are not able to get pregnant for various reasons that we can establish or maybe not even establish, have been associated with developing uterine fibroids.